And now it's time for On the Money with your host, Dan White. Dan has been in the financial services industry for over 25 years, and he's been a featured expert in Forbes, Yahoo, the Philadelphia Business Journal, Dow Jones Market Watch, and has appeared nationally on Fox Business News. Dan is a member of some of the most prestigious financial organizations, including the Society of Financial Service Professionals and the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. In addition, he's a chartered life underwriter and a chartered financial consultant. Credentials you can trust. Broadcasting from the heart of Wilmington, Delaware, here's your host of On the Money, Dan White.
Many could argue that our Social Security system was in critical care the last couple of years. And while the fiscal doctors have not given a complete clean bill of health, there is some good news in the most recent health report. Well, on May 6th, 2024, the Social Security Board of Trustees released their annual report on the financial status of the Social Security Trust Funds. This year's report was delivered as good news. I wouldn't say it is all good news, but better than we thought. Welcome to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. And today, as a Social Security expert, I'm going to break down the Trustees report and what it means for you and your retirement. Before we get into the program, though, we do have a couple announcements. My granddaughter, we have one grandchild. My granddaughter, Ayana, is celebrating her first birthday yesterday on May the 18th. So I want to wish her a happy first birthday, the first lap around the sun. And then our favorite, one of our associate advisors, Brian Wolfer, celebrates his birthday later this week as well. So we want to wish Brian a very happy birthday. Today's giveaway would be the Social Security Update white paper. If you'd like to get a copy of it, you can pick up the phone and give us a call. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, that is 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have several upcoming events this week. On Tuesday, May the 21st at 6 p.m., we'll be at the Chester County Library in Exton, PA. We're doing a Council of Financial Educators workshop. This one is called Women and Retirement. So this educational course, exclusively for women, will help them to better understand your finances and teach you how to create a retirement and financial plan based on sound principles and safe practices. So again, that is Tuesday, May the 21st at 6 p.m. at the Chester County Library. Also on Tuesday the 21st, we have two other programs at 5:30 p.m. We'll be at the Columbus Inn in Wilmington, Delaware at 5:30, and then that will be Andrew Wood. And then Michael Primavera, our new Lewis advisor, will be down at the Fenwick Inn in Ocean City, Maryland at 5:30 p.m. And both of those programs will be our popular Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. So if you are near retirement and just not sure whether you have enough money, you know, you're going to have to take a part-time job, where do you pull money from? These are programs you don't want to miss. And now switching gears to today's topic, the Social Security Trust Fund Report. The Social Security press release reported on the financial status of the combined trust funds. You have the trust for the old age and survivors benefits, and then you have the disability insurance trust, two separate accounts, if you will. Combined, the two trust funds will have enough money to pay all benefits promised until 2035. And that's the good news. That is projected to be 1 year longer than the trustees report for 2023. But if Social Security funding is not financially reformed, by 2035, retirement benefits would be reduced to 79% at that time. This is more good news because that is 2% better than the 2023 trustees report estimated. So there's good news. Good news is where you find it, I guess. You know, Congress is going to have to fix this sometime, probably later rather than sooner. So, you know, we'd like to have it sooner rather than later, but that's not the way Congress does things. So in my mind, this 79% of benefits is still theoretical. In 2023, Social Security paid retirement-related benefits to 62 million people, about one out of every five people in the U.S. today. 183 million people were covered by Social Security in 2023 and paid payroll taxes. That is one in every two people, which is kind of scary. You know, all the people in this country, and only one out of every two pay into Social Security. Total revenue for both trust funds, old age and disability, was $1.35 trillion. Total expenditures were almost $1.4 trillion. So that relatively small difference came out of the trust funds, but it's scheduled to increase annually. Now, Social Security did earn an average of 2.4% interest on asset reserves in the trust funds, almost $2.8 trillion. You're thinking this is big money. It is, including your benefit share. You know, I've got a question why it's 2.4 when, you know, you can get a 5% savings account at the bank. Maybe the government hasn't caught on to that yet. And I suppose the good news is that our big problem has not gotten worse. It's gotten a little better. The Social Security Administration cited the strong U.S. economy, low unemployment, and higher job and wage growth. More Social Security FICA taxes are being paid by more workers and employers on more covered income, and that's increased revenue to Social Security. So that's kind of the good news. But, you know, I look at the report and I say, you know, these prospects haven't materially changed over the last 30 years. Over that time, Washington has unwisely watched the program move closer to insolvency inch by inch, increasing the probability of a benefit reduction for those who depend upon the program. And this wait-and-see strategy has left those now approaching retirement kind of in the lurch, unsure of how much money they will have coming in. A 2023 survey by the investment firm Schroders found 44% of those now approaching retirement plan to claim benefits prior to their full retirement age because they lack confidence in the program's ability to pay the bills. So what we're seeing is people are making probably poor decisions because the government has kind of lollygagged into funding the Social Security. And, you know, for these people, there's no need to wait until 2035. The crisis is here right now. The consequences of the decision to let Americans twist in the wind will play out over decades for those unfortunate enough to live into their 90s. And doing nothing is not a solution. To illustrate, purely as a matter of the passage of time, the program generated over the course of 2022 roughly $800 billion in promises that it does not expect to keep. In 2023, the program added another $800 billion to the tally of empty promises. This is the cost of doing nothing. And when policy experts talk about across-the-board benefit cuts of a specific amount, there's no certainty in how Social Security will work once the trust funds are exhausted. No one actually knows how the program might allocate the system-wide benefit cut to the individual. To illustrate, it is entirely possible that without direction from Congress, that the Social Security Administration will pay benefits in full in arrears. This approach would mean that retirees would get paid in full, but not on the promised day. So a younger worker today might claim benefits at 62 and not receive their first check until 65. So, you know, this is a problem. You know, no one needs this information more than current seniors. At this point, someone who is 80 expects to outlive the program's ability to pay scheduled benefits. That person would be around 89 when insolvency arrives. It's incredibly irresponsible to give false hope that a future Congress might accomplish what the current lawmakers have been unable to do. And even today, there are people who insist that the way to go financially is to delay claiming of benefits to 70, even if someone had to use up his or her full retirement savings in the process. But if those future political alchemists fail, it will leave that delayed claimant to discover at 80 that the source of income he or she was counting on is no longer reliable. And voters need to separate the problem from the consequence. Congressional inaction today is the problem. It enables people even well into retirement to misgauge the gap between what they need and what they will receive. The consequence is a forced reduction in the standard of living of the people who have the least ability to adapt to economic change. And for politicians today, the political calculus of Social Security is limited to looking for a mix of benefit cuts and tax increases that pay for a program that voters love. For the rest of us, the math is a patchwork of guesses at what might happen when Congress can't find the appropriate mix. And the higher tax revenue that is assumed into the future with some assumptions for future growth, the result is that disaster appears to be a year further out in the future. Last year, the combined trust funds were projected to be exhausted in 2034. 11 years later, this year the projection is 2035, which today is 11 years later still. So did we gain a year, or are we just treading water? Let me give you our phone numbers toll-free. You can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942. 610-358-8942. This morning, we're talking about the Social Security Trust Fund report that just came out. It does knock things back another year. But we're going to talk after the break about what this means for you and what it means for you going forward into retirement. We'll have more after the break.
When interest rates go down, you may refinance your mortgage. When interest rates go up like they are now, what do you do with your retirement planning? Have you considered refinancing or reevaluating your current retirement plan? We are now seeing historically high interest rates that can impact your retirement accounts in different ways. Learn how you can take advantage of these attractive rates and how you can seek to avoid the volatility that rising rates create. To learn more, go to danwhiteandassociates.com or call 888-690-8820.
Welcome back to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White, and I am the host of your show. This morning, we're talking about the Social Security Board of Trustees report that was released a little over, say, a week ago or so. And we're going to continue our discussion this morning on what that means for you. I mean, we've been talking about the funding of Social Security, it seems like, for the better part of 15 years. But every year, it gets a little closer, you know. So, we're going to talk about what that means as we continue along this morning. Before we do, though, we do have a couple announcements today. We do have a giveaway, the Social Security Update White Paper. That's a giveaway we have available for anybody today. You just need to call the office, and we're happy to send it out to you. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have three upcoming events this week. On Tuesday, May the 21st at 6 p.m., we have a Council of Financial Educators workshop titled Women and Retirement. This is obviously exclusively for women, and it will help them better understand their finances and teach them how to create a retirement and financial plan based on sound principles and safe practices. So that's Tuesday the 21st at 6. Also on Tuesday at 5:30, we'll be at two other different locations. Andrew Wood will be at the Columbus Inn in Wilmington, Delaware on Route 52, and Mike Primavera will be down at the Fenwick Inn in Ocean City, Maryland. Both of those programs will be our popular Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. So if you'd like to get a reservation to one of these upcoming events this coming week, call the office and get a reservation as quickly as possible. So before the break, we talked about the report and how, you know, it kind of looks a little better. Last year, the trust funds were projected to be exhausted in 2034, 11 years later. This year, the projection is 2035, which is still 11 years later. So did we gain a year, or are we treading water? We're not treading water. The Old Age and Survivors Trust Fund is projected to be depleted during 2033, the same year projected in the 2023 trustees report, and that's not in the press release of May the 6th. The press release also does not mention that the Old Age and Survivors Fund is separate from the Disability Fund. When the Old Age Fund runs out, it cannot just raid the Disability Fund. So what gives? Well, I think there's two possible reasons we are being served up this candy apple right now. This is an election year, and we should not expect someone in the federal government to rock the boat. And second, the trust fund depletion is not a secret, and yet still no steps taken toward a solution. It seems obvious that there is no political gain or election upside for making a federal case over fixing Social Security. My opinion only. Now, the trust fund adequacy and solvency calculations are very complex, and they're based on many factors and many assumptions. They are done for the next 10 years and for the next 75 years as well. It is a best guess by many experts inside and outside Social Security and our government. If no one were looking ahead, our retirement benefits would be suddenly reduced when the trust fund was depleted. That cannot be allowed to happen, so looking ahead is legally required. Nonetheless, if Social Security funding is not fixed, one law will say pay full benefits, and another law says you can only pay the benefit that you have the money to pay. As a result, the Social Security Administration has been telling all of us retirement beneficiaries that we need to urge Congress to protect and support and restore Social Security to the needed long-term funding. The new Commissioner of Social Security, Martin O'Malley, called on Congress in his online video talking about this 2024 trustees report. Take a little walk down memory lane. In 1983, a national commission headed by Federal Reserve Chair Alan Greenspan with participants from both political parties created the proposal for Congress. And that proposal was the basis for the 1983 Social Security reform. Perhaps we will see another such bipartisan commission in one of these coming years. We recognize that the sooner long-term funding of Social Security is fixed, the better it will be for all. The changes required for Social Security to remain adequately funded will be lower in cost and impact if they can be implemented sooner rather than waiting until we reach a cliff looming above the benefit cuts. Whatever changes might be adopted will need to take effect over time. For example, the 1983 changes gradually raised the full retirement age from age 65 to age 67. Those born in 1960 and later have age 67 as their full retirement age. And I expect something like that when any future retirement rule changes and financial fixes. So what might the changes be to fix Social Security? What might they look like? Well, they might raise the full retirement age a few years to maybe age 69 or 70. I mean, there's already precedent for that. It was 65, now it's 67. So they'll probably bump that up. They will probably increase FICA taxes some amount and will probably increase the amount of income subject to the FICA tax. I mean, I can see both of them happening as well. They might increase the income taxes on Social Security retirement benefits because those income taxes are paid back into Social Security now. Some benefits could be reduced, but probably for distant future beneficiaries, I think. There's always some talk of reducing the annual cost of living adjustment. There is talk about indexing the retirement age to increases in longevity. I think tax changes would happen faster than benefit changes. Will Social Security reform change the big advantage of delaying? Maybe for people not yet age 50 or so. Remember, the 8% credit for delaying was chosen in 83 when interest rates were 10% and higher. The 8% you get now for each year of delay might become 5% or so after Social Security reform. That could give you more years of delayed credit if the annual credit rate was much lower. So they might lower the credit rate but give you more years of it. And every year we talk about this, we ask the same question. What does this depletion issue mean to me? Should I claim my Social Security as soon as possible? Should I go back to work? Do I need to do something today? Is there anything I can do? Well, to gain some confidence, you might calculate your optional and optimal claiming strategies if you have not done so in the past 3 years. Social Security benefit calculators assume everything will continue as it is and there will be no future benefit reduction. You want to know what this looks like, even if it is a little rose-colored. Your claiming strategy will evaluate your decision based on your specific circumstances and objectives. Much depends on your age and marital status. This calculation will generally show the reduced benefits for claiming early and the higher benefits for delaying your benefit claiming. For most of us, our optimal claiming decisions will remain the same, whether we assume any reduction or not. Every day we help clients with this calculation. And the biggest question is whether people should claim earlier than they otherwise might just because Social Security might be reduced in the future. The difference between claiming sooner versus claiming later can easily be worth $100,000 to $250,000 for a lifetime. Is claiming Social Security early before benefits are cut a good decision? It might just be a convenient excuse to justify retiring early. It is probably a financial mistake more often than not. I don't think benefits will be cut, but if they were, would you rather get a reduction from a larger check or a smaller check? The advantage of waiting will still be an advantage even if benefits are cut. It would be a smaller advantage, but you should be better off still. If your retirement savings are not very robust and you worry about your total income in retirement, Social Security solvency will be a minor worry for your retirement. Your total income will be your worry instead, so try to raise your Social Security regardless of whether it might be reduced like everyone else. An important strategy to address a reduced retirement income amount is working a little longer or working part-time, which will also help you wait longer to claim Social Security. Our contentious political environment gets some or most of the blame for the lack of action to address long-term Social Security issues. Neither of the two primary political parties want to work together on this issue. It sometimes seems to me that they will do nothing that allows the other side to get credit for something. Doing nothing is the political strategy. So feel free to write, email, or call your representatives in Congress, both House and Senate. Tell them to call a political truce on this one issue and work to pass a solution into law. Feel free to tell them your vote will treat Social Security reform as a voting issue. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll-free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. The Social Security claiming decision is very meaningful, and you owe it to yourself and your family to look at the impact of working longer and claiming later. If we can help you with your Social Security claiming evaluation, give us a call. If you've got questions, we can help you with the answers. Have a great week.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of their respective parties and not those of this show's producers or this station. Join us again for more.